Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Agilent Technology. Today we're going to talk about noisy DMM measurements and what can be done to make a more stable measurement. These noisy readings are really caused by an unwanted AC signal. They can be caused by electromagnetic interference, ground loops, or even a signal that contains both an AC and a DC component. Today, I have a piece of electronic consumer equipment that has both an AC and DC component in its signal. So we're going to work on making both a stable DC and an AC measurement. Let's go ahead and get started with that. Get started with our DC measurement. The first method is to take a bunch of DC measurements. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on mass statistics and look at the average. The average becomes more and more stable with the number of readings being taken. So to get a 10x reduction in noise, we need to take 100 readings. In order to get a 100x reduction in noise, we'll need to take 10,000 readings. So that can be an issue with averaging readings. It can take a long time to come up with a stable average. Okay, I'm going to look at the standard deviation for this particular setup. It's running at about 78 millivolts. Let's move on to our second method and see if we can improve our standard deviation. Our second method is going to take advantage of integrating over a power line cycle. So the idea is most noise is associated with the power line noise. And so by integrating over one cycle of a power line cycle, we can really reject the noise. Integrating over more power line cycles, we're going to do an even better job. So the default setting is one power line cycle. I'm going to go ahead and move up to 10 power line cycles. So we slowed the reading rate down. Again, I'm going to turn math on. But you can see it's much more stable integrating over time. And again, let's go ahead and look at our standard deviation now. So as you can see, the standard deviation has been greatly reduced from the 78 millivolts we saw earlier to less than 20 millivolts DC using this method. So I think we can do even better. So let's take a look at the noise and figure out what the frequency is of the AC component on the signal. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to a frequency measurement. And as you can see, this is the frequency of the switching power supply. It's about 55.7 kilohertz. And if we look at the period, it's 17.9 microseconds. So if we can integrate over that period or a multiple of that period, then we can really reject the noise. So let's go ahead and set that measurement up. So I'm going to go back to DC voltage, and then I'm going to set an aperture of 179 .3. I'm going to accept the rest of the menu. And we'll go back and we'll go ahead and turn on our mass statistics. And once again, we'll go ahead and look at our standard deviation. And so the standard deviation is a little bit lower than what we saw before. The integration time is almost identical to our 10N PLCs. So the reading rate is the same, but by making that slight adjustment, we can really improve the amount of noise that we're seeing on our reading. So let's go ahead and move on to our AC measurement and see what we can do as far as making a stable AC measurement. So this is the default setting for AC measurements. The way AC measurements work is there's actually three filters in the DMM. The default is the medium filter, and these filters are after the RMS converter. And so by changing the filter, we can either speed up the reading rate or we can slow it down. So in our case, we want to slow it down. So I'll pick the slow filter. And by slowing it down, as you can see, the AC reading got much more stable. As you can see, it's easy to filter out unwanted noise and make stable measurements using a few changes to the default settings. Thanks for watching.